The process management plan is a document for the process owner to monitor the process in the future, identify new problems, find their causes, and solve them. The process management plan ensures the sustainability of the implemented measures by monitoring of the future process performance with control charts and by responses to performance drops determined in a reaction plan. The starting point in SigmaGuide is again the defined problems and their measurement operationalized already in the data collection plan. In the analysis and control phase so far, we wanted to get a first impression of the performance of the process before and immediately after improvement. And we were interested in extreme values and patterns in the data. Now, it's about controlling the process in the future, possibly without your participation, so using the control chart as a diagnostic tool for the employees and the process owner. Let me suggest a simple strategy for developing this control chart. First, I choose an appropriate time interval for the regular updating of the control chart to monitor the taste of our cookies. You can schedule the interval weekly, biweekly, monthly, or quarterly. I prefer close monitoring, at least at the beginning. That's why I'm planning to let our customers test the taste weekly, with a sample size of 25 cookies. The 25 data can also be displayed very clearly as individual values in a control chart, and therefore I get the proposal IMR chart. I personally think that up to 100 values can be resolved by an IMR chart. The IMR chart is also my personal favorite, but of course it doesn't always fit. Depending on the scale level, sample size, and the number of displayed data points, the X-bar-R, X-bar-S, P, and U charts are also suggested. In addition to the control chart type, we must now determine the control limits and the center line. In contrast to the defined specification limits, the control limits are calculated based on the standard deviation or the moving range. Each new value and of course a high volatility in the data then always leads to new and therefore to probably inappropriate control limits. That is why I would like to use proven reference values in the future. If we start with a new process, then we must estimate the control limits and the center line from the actually underlying sample. For future monitoring, however, it is important to derive reference values from a controlled process phase. In the example, I measured data over 2 weeks. In the menu to the preliminary control chart, I first choose Estimate from the data. Even before the chart is displayed, the menu already immediately shows the identified signals and allows them to be selectively excluded from the calculation. If signals are already displayed in the dialog, then exclude at least the extreme values. This is because these outliers determine the standard deviation disproportionately and thus extend your control corridor disproportionately. The result for the first week shows the already known cause, and the excluded outliers are indexed as signals here. In the second week, the data shows a smooth controlled course. I would like to make this second controlled period the basis of my reference value calculations. Therefore, I copy the data of this controlled period into a new variable and let for a new control chart again estimate the limits and center line from these data. If necessary, I exclude the now identified extreme values calculated for this period again. This new control chart now only shows the controlled course of the second week. So that this control period can serve as a reference for the future course, I enter the calculated values for the limits and center lines as known values in the table of the menu for the final control chart. For examination, I generate this chart for the data from both periods. Compared to the first control chart, you can see that almost all values of the first uncontrolled week are now outside the control limits, and the data of the controlled period are now within the control corridor in the same way as with the second control chart. Now we have created an ambitious reference for checking future data. These calculated values for the control limits and the center line can now be entered in the process management plan. Finally, you can specify who is responsible for maintaining the control chart and the reaction plan and enter the file name of the reaction plan. The reaction plan determines under which conditions, for example signals in the control charts, what must be done by whom. This reaction plan is not part of Sigma Guide and should be created according to your company standard. Of course, the process owner and his employees must be informed about the use, maintenance, and above all, about the potential signals in control charts. The installation of a continuous improvement team would be ideal, if there is not yet one, in which the results of the control charts are discussed weekly, extreme values and patterns are examined for causes, and suitable solutions are developed. I'd like to recommend that you accompany this team for a while, so that they get used to the work with its results and indications. To support the team, you could easily rebuild simple control charts, for example with Excel. Maybe your sponsor is even willing to build a process dashboard with the control charts and their updates. In any case, these dashboards should always be in view, one for the staff and one for the process owner. This would have introduced or added visual management to your department.